Hallelujah. Blessed people of God. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you so much. He loves the whole world. He loves sinners. So he loves Muslim people. He loves Christians as well. He loves the unbelievers. Let us know this. The heart of God is love. God loves the whole world. Let us stop this hatred. Let us stop it. Our God is love. And let us demonstrate love to the whole world. When the whole world truly see love, because love is God, when they truly see this genuine love, this true love in us, they will respond. They will respond to us. They will be at the feet of Jesus Christ. Okay, so I am talking today about a scripture. That's a scripture that I want to talk about. Jesus said in the book of John chapter 10 verse 11. John chapter 10 verse 11. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. So this scripture caught my mind. I read it again, but just listen. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. Let me use this scripture. Fulani Herdsmen demonstrated this scripture more than Nigerian pastors. Fulani Herdsmen, they value the life of their cow more than anything. They are the shepherd. They are, what is the shepherd? The shepherd is the one leading the sheep. So they cares for the life of their cows, of their animals, more than themselves. They protect the cow from enemy. They took the cow to the green pasture. Anywhere they hear that there's a green grass, they will make sure that they lead their cows to that place. They will pass through dangerous forest bushes in search of food for their cows. When the cows are thirsty, they will take any risk to see that they quench the thirst in their cow, for their cow to have water to drink, to quench their thirst, when they are thirsty. When the enemy show up, they will start to fight. They will fight with everything within them to protect the life of their cows, of their animals. I look at this scripture, I say, these people have demonstrated this scripture more than Nigerian pastors. Nigerian pastors, for this scripture, is the opposite. The members is the one, if there's danger, their members is the one fighting. Even as I'm trying to help them, and many people are trying to help them to open their eyes, they are the one launching attack, defending their pastor. Because if their pastor knows that they are capable, they can write me, or they can call me, or they can contact me, I will do it one-on-one with them. But instead, it's their member that they will tell them to go and begin, like Suleiman, anybody that say anything against them, attack. Why can't you, Suleiman, stand and attack? Why can't you defend? I'm using you as a point of contact to other pastors, because it's all what's going on in the whole Nigeria. The members are the one defending the shepherd. The sheep are the one defending the shepherd. Right? When the shepherd is thirsty, the members are the one that will go to any extreme. Thirsty means when they need anything, the members is the one that will go and bring something for them to drink. Because thirsty means a lot. I want to analyze now. Between your pastors are thirsty, they will send you to go and look for water for them. Instead of you to tell your pastor, "Pastor, I'm thirsty," for him to go to any extreme, to go to an, you know, an extent to see that your thirst in life is quenched. Your pastor sit down, you are the one doing the other side. He's supposed to go and search for water for you. He's supposed to search water for you. When your pastor is moving, he is moving with bodyguard, heavy bodyguards, armed men, protecting them. But you are going without nobody protecting you. After the service, you are going in anything, you're on your own. Even if you call them that, okay, you had an accident or anything happens to you, you're on your own. But they will be going with bodyguards, with a armored car, armed police with AK-47 surround them, protecting them. But the sheep, anything can happen to them. Anything can happen to you that is gullible, without sense, because they have done something on your brain. Your brain is no more human. It's no more God image. It's a beast. You're thinking like an animal. You don't think like human anymore. So they have done some things on your brain. You don't think anymore. So because you're thinking like human, you say, "Why will my pastor after service, he's going home with bodyguard? Why is it that when he's preaching, bodyguard?" You're supposed to think by yourself. When it comes to green pasture, you are the one that is going to an extent to see, make your pastor rich, moving with jets, Rolls Royce, Cadillac, Lamborghini, living in a mansion, while you are going with footbed. You are trekking, or from Surulele, or anywhere you're living. You can trek from Surulele to Ikoyi to go and hear their sort of nonsense and drop money. You can move from Okota to Maryland to go and give them money because they happen to offer you for them to release empty walls for you. The rain will beat you, sun will hit you, but they are going with 100 cars in a convoy without thinking about you. I give Fulani Herdsmen credit. I go through the scripture, I give them credit. Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd." Jesus demonstrated this scripture because the word of God is life. It's not something you speak from your mouth without practicalizing it. Jesus came. He is the good shepherd. He gave his life. He surrendered his life. He sold his life. He died for the sheep. When the sheep is hungry, he feed them. When the sheep is thirsty, give them something to drink. He makes sure that their thirst is quenched, that he satisfied them. When they are naked, he clothed them. And he's still doing it today. When the enemy show up, he will shout Jesus. He will land and begin to slaughter the enemy. I mean, to handle the enemy that wants to kill you in the life. That's why you are trusting your pastor that he's having Jesus, so that if you go to him, he will release more power of Jesus, more power of the Holy Spirit in you, so that any demon that show up, you can massacre, you can castrate every devil and demon. Instead, they are the one releasing more demons so that you keep on running to them, coming to them. And before you come, say, "Oh, I see you, I them," because they are the one that send those attacks to you so that you keep coming to them. So you are poor, you cry, "Jesus, help me," one way or the other. In a day, he makes sure that you find something to eat. You are sick, say, "Jesus," you are crying to him. Up to today, by his spirit, he hears you and come and heal you. This is the good shepherd. The good shepherd laid his life, gave his life for the sheep. But your pastors are the one today, the opposite of it. You are the one protecting them. If an enemy appear, they will tell you, begin to fight for me, fight. Your pastor, if he's anointed, supposed to open their mouth and talk to Buhari, even they will be, by now, Buhari would have been dead, but they are the one protecting him. If they are from God, evil in Nigeria would have been eliminated. One man, only one man, Jesus, handled the whole devil, handled the devil and the demons in the world, get them down for the sheep, get all the enemy destroyed. But how many pastors is parading? Are you parading in that country called Nigeria? How many of them? Can't you now listen to me and think, understand perfectly that these men are the enemy of your soul? Understand it perfectly. It's time. I want you to understand this. I want your common sense to come back to life. You lack common sense. You lack common sense. Your soul is more precious than silver and gold, more important for you. Let the veil they use, the juju, the veil, get out of your eyes. Let that do as I said. They are traveling from one nation, from India to Asia, in search of power to blindfold you. And when they speak, you begin, do as I said. As a child of God, say no to that. I will not do as any man said. I will only do what the word of God said. From this moment, I decree, I say, every veil in your eyes, every veil, every jinx, every curse, be broken. Be broken now. Be broken now. Every blindness, be removed out of your eyes. Every bewitched, I say, I cast it. They are busy bewitching you people of Nigeria, causing damage, causing havoc, spreading that crowd to the tree of God. I say that can be rolled away now, and let them be clotted and covered with that darkness now. Let darkness cover them. Let evil bury evil now. And I decree, let the light of justice shine now in the whole world. Shine now in your life, in Nigeria. Let the light of justice shine now. I just want to give you this. And I decree from this moment, let your common sense come back. Come back to you. You lack common sense. African people, you lack common sense. You need common sense. And I command, without common sense, you cannot do it. I decree common sense from this moment.